In this video today, I'll build a jungle outpost diorama in 1:72 scale, made from mostly cardboard and paper scrap. I start with a large 8x10 inch piece of cardboard for the base. Then, I draw the layout of the base to get an idea of how it will look. And we are good to go. Let's start building. To give the base its form, I added on two more layers of cardboard. To prevent warping, I glued on pieces of paper to the edges of the cardboard. Then for what will be the water surface, I glued on one large piece of paper. For the ground texture of the base, I used some soil that I gathered from outside. I had the base, except for the water surface area, coated in PVA glue, then dusted on the soil. While letting the glue set, I made a small pier using a piece of cardboard. To make the texture of the wooden planks, I scored them on horizontally with a razor blade. And for the posts holding the planks, I used a piece of rolled up paper. Once they are set, I carefully place each plank in position. However, I had to remove the pier in order to make it easier to paint the water and to apply the gloss effect. With the base itself finished, we can now move on to building the bamboo house. For this, I used a discarded candy bar box. Once all the excess areas are cut, I then drew on the windows. I then have them cut out, but will glue them back on after adding the wall texture to the exterior. Next, I glued on the wooden planks for the floor texture. For the thatched wall texture, I used strips of peeled cardon. Doing so, I glue one strip horizontally. Then, four on top of it vertically. Then an additional three more below it. Then, I pulled the rest of the strips into position in the following pattern shown. Once finished, I then glued the window shutters back in place, where I then cut along the bottom and side grooves to let the shutters open. Now, we have windows that can open or close. I then made the corners of the roof, in which I also added the texture to. Then, I added on the wall texture to the interior. Then, I added a bit more texture to the outside walls. And once finished, I had the house assembled. Using rolled up peeled cardon, I made the canvas door covers. For the roof, I used two pieces of cardon. The large one, however, will not be glued, as it will be removable. To make the roof texture, I scored them on vertically with a razor blade. Then for the rest of the texture, I glued on strips of cardon. Once finished adding the texture, I glued on the smaller roof. Next, I then made the railing outside of the house. For the bamboo stilts holding up the house, I used toothpicks and barbecue skewers. To add the toothpicks without breaking them, I use a pin needle as a post digger. Once finished, I dry fitted on the house. And let's not forget the ladders, which won't be glued on just yet. And we are done building, for the most part. Moving on to painting, before I begin, I primed the base and house. And on to painting, I start with the ground base coat. Then, I painted on a lighter sand color for the driveway. Then, I painted on the three layers of the water. Next, I painted on the color for the pier. Then, I gave the stilts a light greenish beige. And a dark green beige for the house. Then, I added on a dark earth shade wash. Once painted, it's time to add the vegetation, starting with grass. Next, I added on the foliage clumps. I then drew a few types of plants, then cut them out. Using the outlines of the cutouts, I stenciled on the rest of the plants. And once all were cut out, I assembled them. Then, I had them painted in various shades of bright green. To add the plants in without damaging them, I use a barbecue skewer as a post digger. Then, I added on two palm trees, which I made from paper, which you can see in one of my previous videos. With the plants and trees finished, I then make the furniture for the interior. First, I start with some chairs and tables. Then, I made the radio equipment. Then, I made crates, barrels, and tools. I then have them painted and glue the accessories onto the tables. Once made, I then glue them in place. Now, we can glue the house and ladders into place. I glue on the crates, barrels, and tools. And to give the water a realistic appearance, I coated on PVA glue to its surface area. Then, I glued the pier back into place. And to finish it, I added some figures. I glued the figure holding the fishing rod first, while the glue was still setting, in order to adjust the line. And after a few hours, the glue has set, and we get a natural look of the water. Now, we can add the rest of the figures. It also provides a base for the Type 1 half track. That's also all for this one. I hope y'all liked it.